Hello, everyone. I have a phone here and a German binocular, Soviet binocular, monocular, Svbony. It doesn't matter. Svbony or any other binocular is just a binocular with roof prisma. For the most part, they look almost identical at the moment. And I also have these two adapters. These adapters are for attaching a phone to the eyepiece. These adapters can be attached to both binoculars and telescopes. So, as you might have guessed, in this video, I'm going to talk about adapters for mobile phones. Here's this kind of adapter. Most of the time, it comes included with some telescope. And this one, if someone wants, they can buy it separately. Look, it doesn't really matter what this is. Basically, modern telescopes have an eyepiece diameter about this size. This one is plastic, cheap, and convenient, inexpensive and effective. You just put it on here, set it up vertically or horizontally, and attach it. You put it on here, you can set it up vertically like this, or you can do it horizontally, and then you attach it. This is my old phone, I don't use it anymore. And, well, I don't know. I used it for 4 years, the battery completely died, and now it just sits around. All my phones that I have used, I still have them, I don't throw them away. And this is how it attaches. Well, then you can start recording something. And this is how it attaches. So then you can start recording something. Basically, this kind of thing is perfect for telescopes. It's already for binoculars. It doesn't fit very well, but if you take this one, you see it says Holstront. Well, that's not important. It costs about, well, maybe $30-$40, and it's as fashionable as you can see. Here, there's an adjustment for up and down. Let me secure the phone so it's clearer. You can adjust it in height, up and down, and also left and right. And there's one more feature here. And you can pull the camera away from the eyepiece like this. On one hand, it's cool and trendy, but it's not that universal. Because if you take the eyepiece, but from some telescope, it's quite convenient. You see, it adjusts to whatever is comfortable. Mounting is hard. This kind of binocular with a roof prism. If you try to mount it on the right side, it might work. But there's also diopter correction, which can just, the image will turn out. You have to focus centrally, and it has shifted, and now the image is not clear, so it's better to mount it on the left side. It still gets in the way, you know, it's somewhat bulky. It's not easy for people to mount it like that, especially with this kind of binoculars that have eyepieces like this. It's not that easy for people to mount it. Also, with this kind of binoculars that have eyepieces like in Bony, with roof prisms, it's still somewhat manageable to adjust. For example, if we take this one, here you see, it's just impossible to mount it. It will constantly bounce off. The same goes for the left eyepiece, it's also impossible. If we take this one, well, for example, like with your phone and camera here on the side, you mount it, insert it here, but the camera doesn't align with the center of the eyepiece. It's also impossible to do it like this. It's getting in the way, you know. It's not all that simple with those adapters. Now let's take this one, which was sent to me for repair. Well, I mean, it's impossible to mount them here. I was looking online for something universal, compact, that would be convenient for me. And I found this magnetic adapter, which you can buy on AliExpress. Look here, you see, its price is 1600 hryvnias. So you see, delivery is roughly 2000, which means it will cost about $40-$50. And there's no guarantee that this magnetic adapter will fit perfectly. Maybe its magnetic strength isn't that strong, and the phone will just fall off. You see, is it magnetic? Does it attach to the phone case, or does it somehow slide under the phone case? Well, nevertheless, it cost $50. And if I knew for sure that it would fit me perfectly, maybe I would buy it. But I don't know that. But just buying it like that, spending $50, I really don't want to. So I decided to try to make something similar on my own. Maybe it will work out. I have this metal clamp or metal fastener. I have these metal plates. I will use them, either stick them to the phone or slide them under the cover. And I also have these little magnets. These little magnets are sold here in Ukraine. Well, for example, in Epicenter, in the department for fasteners, where the screws and various nuts are, there are also these kinds of magnets. I wanted to buy them. Everything for fastening, where the screws are, all kinds of nuts, there are also these kinds of magnets. I wanted to buy them. I looked at the price, 40 hryvnias or 50 hryvnias, it cost 4 magnets, they were packed like this. Well, that means one magnet is 10 hryvnias. How many magnets will I need to put here? I still don't know, but I figured it won't be too many, so it will turn out to be cheap. So I ordered these little magnets, each measuring 5 millimeters like this one cube, that is 5x5x5. I ordered 100 pieces on AliExpress. They ended up costing me about 3 hryvnias each. Well, that's already, you know. Where it's 3/8 hryvnias, where it's 10, it seems like a small difference. But if a lot of magnets go into this, it will cost a bit. Well, at the moment, what I've spent money on is just these magnets. So, it will cost a bit for the magnets. Well, so far, the only thing I've spent money on is these magnets. I bought 100 of them, but I don't need that many. But it was impossible to order fewer. It's nothing serious, let it be. So I had these things, and now I just need to figure out how I'm going to glue them. I haven't figured it out yet. I'll try to see if it's going to be some kind of glue, or sealant, or this gun. You know, like, I'm heating up the glue. I don't know. Well, I'll give it a try. You'll see the result in just a couple of seconds, but I'll need, well, probably about an hour. Maybe I'll need to try 2 or 3 types of glue at first. Now, take a look at what I've got. I made 2 of these mounts. There is here, I glued 20 magnets, like this. And here I have 12 rows of 3 magnets. So, that makes 36 magnets. And if we multiply, let's say roughly multiply by 4 hryvnias per magnet, that comes to about 150 hryvnias. Here are 80 hryvnias. If we convert it to dollars at the beginning of 2025, this will cost a maximum of $3. And this is probably $4. Of course, I won't leave them like this. I will need to wrap them with something else. I might put on the heat shrink tubing so that when I change the radius while I'm turning it here, maybe this glue will work. I used glue that can peel off. With this kind of glue, so this is not the final work yet. It still needs some finishing touches. Well, of course, I need to check if it will hold the phone. So now let's summarize. Here, where there were 2 magnets, I had a suitable size of tubing. I put it on, dipped it in boiling water, and it shrank. But 2 magnets. Well, not really, if it has enough strength. This is a Sony phone. I glued 2 metal plates here. The plates, its weight is 170 grams. Well, it seems to hold with its last strength, and I like this holder with straight magnets much more. The phone holds much more reliably. But going back, if you're going to do something like this, keep in mind that you need to first unscrew this connector, straighten it out, and then, on such a straight metal strip, glue the magnets, wrap them either with tape or put on the tubing, and only then push it through the thread. Because when you glue them, glue the magnets, wrap them either with tape or put on the tubing, and only then push them through the thread here. Because when you glue them on the bent clamp, you'll be straightening it out, and the magnets might peel off a little. On the bent clamp, you'll be straightening it out and the magnets might peel off a little. So now take another look. Well, 170 grams. Well, 170, it holds quite firmly. Grams. It holds quite firmly. Now I'll tap it like this, see? It doesn't fall. My phone too. Sony. Its weight is 190 grams. Magnets. I didn't glue it, I just shoved it under the case. It holds too. Well, just shake it like that. I haven't tried it yet, but when you set it up like this, the phone doesn't fall off. So, now let's try it. As you can see, we placed the phone, and this is how we hold it in our hands, or rest it on something. Well, this will be better. Then like this, hold the phone in your hands and try to aim for the center of the lens. All right, now we're going to try filming. It's a bit foggy outside. Well, that's that binoculars. I've attached it to the left lens. Let's flip the binoculars over and let's give it a try. Oops, it slipped a bit. Well, it's much more convenient, I can tell you right away. Now I'll try filming through some other binoculars. Let's flip it over too. Something on the edges. It's a pretty average image. This binocular is wide angle. Well, now here's one of my favorite binoculars. It's an old one from 1942, Westinghouse 630. Here I hung the magnet on the right eyepiece since there is a goniometric grid in the left eyepiece. In general, I plan to shoot soon my little collection of binoculars. I wouldn't say it's really a collection, I've just kept them for myself for now. These are the binoculars that I like. Some of them are rare, and some of them, well, they're not rare binoculars at all, but let them be. They don't take up much space and won't go bad. Thank you all for watching the video. If you liked it, support the channel, give it a thumbs up, and please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And until we meet again.